come back for us, we would only do this here at the New Jersey Kiss Expo! You ready? How about we kick some ass?
Talking metal here. We're feeling hotter than hell in this hotel room right now. It is hotter than hell in here, isn't it?
It's more like stuffy as hell.
Stuffy as hell.
It's stuffy as hell.
I'm having a blast here at the Kiss Expo in Parsippany, New Jersey tonight with Kiss Nation, Billy May, and Ruby. How are you doing?
Great. It's an honor to be here. We try to come out and do these expos anytime that the New Jersey Expo comes around. We've been the house band now for years. This is the biggest one. We've got Ace Frehley. We've got Lita Ford. And what was great for us is we get to come in, do a full show on the Friday night, which was our standard set. Tomorrow we do Unmasked and Unplugged. And then we're honored to share the stage with Ace Frehley. And we're going to dig out some deep cuts and some classics for all the hardcore Kiss fans this weekend.
And this is home for us. You know, this is home. Jersey Expo. And we've been part of the Jersey Expo for several years. And we love doing this show. It's amazing. We love the fans. We love the local New York Jersey Kiss fans. And it's just no other place like doing this expo. We love it. We're thrilled and honored to be here.
The beauty of it was tonight seeing all the fans that know who you guys are and have seen you, but I love watching the newbies, like the people that have never seen you before and their reactions to, because you guys are hands down.
What are their reactions?
The world premiere, the best in the world, the best Kiss,
hottest Kiss tribute band in the world.
Hottest and the most talented.
I feel like we I would owe you a check now.
No, but I mean this from the bottom of my heart. My talking metal listeners know I don't say something if I don't believe it. And I'm one of those people that likes to look around the audience and see reactions. And the reactions I saw tonight were just staggering. Everyone was blown away by you guys. You killed it.
Well, thank you.
I think it's you know, part of the reason you get up there is just to look out and see the people that appreciate a lot of the same things that you do. And if you can get up there and share that with them, it makes the show more worthwhile. But for me tonight, the particular thing that I was looking at was Lita Ford in the back.
Oh my God. I know. Could I tell you, I've never seen Mark blush so hard. And he has interviewed her numerous times, but he made a beeline for Lita tonight, and I took about 75 pictures. So you guys will see them all on Talking Metal soon.
I want a picture with Lita.
Everyone wants a picture with Lita, as they should want a picture of Lita.
We love you, Lita.
We really do. So tell me how you guys got involved with the Expo, because it's your first time playing the Expo. Is that correct?
No, we've played them the last several years.
Different locations.
Yeah.
Different locations.
Peter Arquette's been running the Expo in this area for the last few years, and we did them each year. And you know, Peter's a great guy, and this year they really wanted to go all out, and Keith LaRue and Phil Dealey got involved. And, you know, we've had a long relationship with all those guys, so it just seemed logical and it just seemed natural that when this was going to come together, we would be part of it. And for us, we wanted to be part of it in as many ways, in any ways that we could, which gave us the opportunity to do multiple nights and multiple shows and stuff like that. So that's why we're here.
And awesome. Like we said before, this is the biggest one. I mean, obviously, look at me. Ace Frehley is here. There's no way that I don't want to do this show. I mean, come on.
Ace is in the house, y'all. And Ace is doing...
Not me. Ace. Real it. Not me. I'm not really Ace.
Ace Frehley. Yeah, you could have fooled me tonight, though.
Oh, thank
Shock
you.
Me was killing. You were killing. Thank you so much.
Awesome. Much too kind.
So
we can do a talking metal like after hours show where Mark and I sit down and tell ace stories from 25 years ago that we've experienced.
You absolutely could, and we probably should do this, but you know what I would like to hear?
I would like to edit all of that out.
So the interview would be 15 seconds long.
Exactly. You would have to edit it all out. I want to hear about the first time you, what's your first memory of Mark Striegel? Let's talk a little talking metal like history here. You've known Mark for a long time. What are some of your early memories of my husband?
I've known Mark for about 25 years, and we had a mutual friend that he played in a band with. I remember Mark was in a band called Roy's Baby, and Mark was much cooler than me, because it was sometime in the early 90s, and Mark was really just trying to get ahead of the curve and kind of play like what was hot, what was happening.
He's always ahead of the curve, right?
Yeah, he was right there, and I didn't get it. I'd go on, what are they doing? Drop D tuning and this and that. I wanted to play, you know, Toys in the Attic and Exile on Main Street. And this guy was, you know, a couple of steps ahead. And I was scratching my head. And I ended up painting my face like Kiss for the next 30 years. And he's got a show. So
it's worked out for you.
Worked out for both of us. Yeah.
I think you both ended up where you're supposed to be. Absolutely. And tell me about your relationship with Kiss. Because you're one of the few tribute bands that Kiss acknowledges. I've seen pictures of you.
It's very private.
I'm going to hear.
That's very private. That's very private.
Look, Kiss have always been kind to, I think, all of us.
We're very lucky.
Yeah.
Very
and,
fortunate.
I think I wouldn't say that they acknowledge us as if we're a special tribute band or anything like that, but some of us have been fans for a long time, and it's been easy for us to be recognized by them, and I think each one of the guys has always been gentleman and charming to us in any way that they could. So I don't have anything bad to say about any of the members in that band, and it's kind of them to be able to allow us to get out and play their songs and use their makeup and stuff like that. So they're all great guys.
Any and every experience we've had with the band has been nothing but positive, and very fortunate. In that case, I mean, yeah.
That's amazing. That's so cool to hear. I love hearing that, because I know that they can see what you guys are doing, and you guys just, you do them justice, and I've seen some tribute bands that don't, and you guys do, and that's what, like, warms my heart about you guys.
Who? I'm sorry. No.
I think Mark came home one day, and I was sitting in the living room playing Monopoly with Ace. You were there that night,
oh
right?
God.
Yeah, it's a true story. Yeah, Mark comes home, walks into the living room. This was specifically to make Mark laugh. I remember Mark walking in, and it must have been a surreal sight to look, and there's Ace Frehley in the living room, and me, and a couple of other people playing Monopoly.
Playing Monopoly.
Monopoly. Yeah.
You know what piece?
Yeah.
Ace
what piece
used?
Was Ace? Was he the shoe?
Tell me, was the shoe?
You know, I really can't remember. There was also a lot of champagne.
Just lie to me and tell me it was the shoe.
Hold on. Why is the shoe really the only piece I remember?
Well, the dog. There was a Scotty. Okay. Scotty dog.
He was the car, but he drove it the wrong way.
Oh, that's even.
No, we're talking about the game, right?
Do not go directly to jail. Do not pass go. Do not collect.
If you say Ace drove it the wrong way, we're talking about the game.
This is the coolest interview ever. I'm so excited. Where can I see you guys next?
Like, tomorrow.
Tomorrow. Here.
Without this.
Yeah. This isn't going to be edited by tomorrow, because we're all going down to the bar after
Sunday.
This.
Sunday.
Us. Yeah. They can see us on YouTube from the clips that you guys post.
Yes, they will.
Right now, we do this nationally. So wherever it comes up, where there's a good gig to go out and do it, we'll head out to it. Awesome. But the holidays are coming up, and vacations, and winter. So we've kind of slowed down. So this weekend kind of ends out some of the shows. And then we'll be back probably, I would guess, around March or April.
Everyone, check it out on YouTube, on Talking Metal. We're going to have some clips up. Everything will be posted. And here tonight with Kiss Nation, so excited to see you guys. You guys killed it. And thank you for coming on Talking Metal.
Thanks for having us. Thank you.